Hi, I'm Stu. Welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Now, did you know that there are four different ways to apply a transition in LumaFusion? So let's take a look at them. Now, before we go about applying transitions, we need to go into our help and settings and set our clip default for the transition. Now, generally speaking, I think the default's around about 2 seconds, but I tend to have it very short, around about 8 frames, because I like my transitions to be generally snappy, and then I can lengthen them using the techniques that I'm going to show you. My advice is have your transition settings to be shorter in your project. Set your clips roughly to 0.5 seconds. But as I say, I like them to be snappy, so I go for 8 frames. So the first way of applying a transition is the one you've probably seen me use the most. Now, if you're going to stick to your clip default, in my case, 8 frames, then dragging a transition and dropping it in is absolutely fine. But if you're wanting to adjust the clip, dragging and dropping actually is completely counterintuitive. So I'm going to show you a way that you can apply the transition, but also set the duration on the fly. Okay, so what you do is select the item on your timeline you want to add a transition to. In this case, we're going to do it to the around the world type. You then want to select transition. In this case, we're going to use the cross dissolve. Now, as before, if you're at the beginning of the clip, you drag and drop, it will apply your 8 frames transition as per the clip default. But also, if you double tap the transition, it will apply the transition at the beginning at 8 frames. Here's the trick though. If you have selected your clip and you move into a preset amount, for example, we could come into 1 second. Now, if you double tap, you will get a 1 second transition. So just by choosing the point at which you want the transition to be, let's say on the globe time lapse, 2 seconds and 21 frames. If I then double tap my dip, that will then give me that 1 second at 9 frame dip at the back end. You can watch it like this. So that's a much faster, much more intuitive way of applying a transition. Select the clip, choose the point where you want the transition to be applied. If it's at the clip default, then by all means, leave it at the clip default. In my case, 8 frames, and yours it may be longer or less. However, if you want it to be completely different, then choose a different position in the timeline. So for example, I could go for 1 second, 20 frames, and double tap across dissolve once again. That will then give me a 1 second, 20 frames across dissolve on the text around the world. The other method of applying a transition to either text or video clips is to use the insert to main button. So the first thing we're going to do is just highlight text again. We will choose, I think, around 1.5 seconds, which in this case will be 1 second, 15 frames. And then all you've got to do is make sure you've got the appropriate transition and then just tap the insert to main button. And there you go, transition has been applied. If you're used to using the insert to main button on your iPhone, then this is actually quite a good way of applying a transition instead of dragging and dropping to the clip default length. The keyboard shortcut method is by far the easiest way to apply a basic cross dissolve transition. And as before, if you're at the beginning of a clip, highlight it, press T, and you've got yourself a cross dissolve at the clip default length. However, our settings we've already worked out, in this case 1 second, 15 frames, can also be applied just by pressing T on the keyboard. You'll then get a longer cross dissolve. So it's up to you which transition type you use. My personal favourite these days is to double tap and pick the position where I want the transition to actually land. But sometimes I use drag and drop, and sometimes I use, if I just need a cross dissolve, the keyboard method. It really depends on the project.
If you like the video, then give it a thumbs up, as it really helps the channel. Don't forget to subscribe for more video tutorials every week. And ring the bell to get notified of when Stu has uploaded a new video tutorial. You have been watching. I am Stu. See you later.